Hi, I'm Julie, and this is Plants to the Rescue. And today we're going to talk about holiday madness, and especially something that I've heard so many times, and I'm sure probably some of you have heard it too. One little bite ain't gonna hurt ya. I can't even tell you how many times I've heard that. So I'm going to talk about whether one little bite will in fact hurt me or will not hurt me. And maybe some of this will resonate with you. So I want you to see, I'm exhausted, by the way. I went hiking today and I did laundry today and I cooked and I cleaned and I went shopping today and I've done all kinds of stuff today. So, and it is late and I'm doing this late. So please bear with me and realize that I'm completely tired. But I wore a special shirt because I knew I was gonna try to make this video today. And the shirt says, love yourself. All right, so that's part of what all of this madness means to me about that one little bite won't hurt you. And how do I love myself, be with the fam, be with the friends, and remember to love myself? And will that one little bite hurt me? So I've been at this for a long time, and I can tell you that I have taken so many detours in this weight loss journey. It has taken me so much longer than it needed to lose 190 pounds. It's taken me years and years. And part of the reason, believe it or not, that it's taken me so long to lose this weight is because of the holidays. Yep, holidays. Holidays are or have been my kryptonite. And I don't know if it's like that for any of you. And I will do so well, day in, day out, week after week after week. But unfortunately, there's usually about one holiday per month, at least in my family. We really, really, really like the holidays a lot. And we always have. And holidays in my family meant food. They still mean food, at least in my extended family, quite a bit. And I grew up, I'm not Italian, but my stepfather is Italian, and I grew up in an Italian-American household, and mangia, mangia, eat, 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 and eating means love. And my mom, she wasn't Italian, but she grew up in a really, really, really poor household, and they didn't always have enough food when she was growing up. They were downright hungry. So when my mom had a family of her own, she was bound and determined that no one would ever go hungry. And she took that job super seriously. And my mom is the most wonderful lady in the world, but she's a food pusher. She really is. And it's her way of expressing love. And it's something that she learned very young. And I don't think it's going to change. I really don't. So what I have to change and I have to adapt, and it is super hard. And as I was saying before, it's taken me much longer to lose 190 pounds because when the holidays roll around, I have bought into the one bite won't hurt you. And I have bought into the, I mean, Sean and I have talked so many times and we're like, you know what? We can do it. We can do it. We'll go on a Mary's Mini the next day. We'll go on a fast for a couple of days. We'll just eat all fruits and vegetables for a little while after the holidays. We have bargained with ourselves 8 million times, 8 million different ways of how we would fix our holiday binges. Like, being a vegan in our family is non-negotiable. It's been non-negotiable for over 12 years. So we do luck out in that way. We do not have to partake in anything that is non-vegan because our family's great about our veganism. They really are. And I yay to my family. Sean, myself, and my son are the only vegans in the family. But my extended family has never given me a hard time about being vegan, which is kind of crazy. My stepfather was a hunter his whole life, and it's kind of crazy that they've never given me a hard time, but they really haven't. In fact, they've tried to make it more comfortable for me to be a vegan. And my mom, many times in the past, got delighted by all of the foods that she found with that vegan symbol on them. All the chocolates and all the non-dairy ice creams and there's so much. There's so much out there. You guys all know that. There's so much vegan goodies out there. And my mom, for a while, was even making some really decadent vegan recipes that she had found, and all in trying to love us. And so, for many, 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 many times in this journey, Sean and I have tried to make these bargains with ourselves of how do we get through the holidays? Well, you know what? It is only one day, but it's not true. That's not even true. Because if your family's anything like my family, it isn't just one day, especially during the Christmas season. My birthday falls on December 22nd, so we've got that. And then you've got the work parties, the holiday work parties, or family and friend get-togethers. And then it's Christmas Eve, and well, that's celebrations too. And then it's Christmas Day, and that celebration seems to go on sometimes straight till January 2nd, at least in my family. There's always another platter of cookies. There's always another fancy bread. There's always some fudge, truffles, you name it, everywhere. And while we don't have to partake in the things that aren't vegan, and they're great about it and never push that stuff on us, they still, I bought you these special vegan chocolates, or I bought you this special thing, or I made you this special dessert. And it's vegan, and they're so excited, and they just want to share, and they want to share their love. And what do we do? What do we do when that stuff happens? We're already used to bringing our own main dishes. We've been doing that for years. And they make room in the fridge, and we bring our main dishes, and nobody wants them. Every now and then, my mom, when I made a make vegan desserts that aren't whole food plant-based. My mother does like them. But nobody else wants Julie's vegan food when they can have the stuff with dairy and all that stuff. So we're safe with the main dishes and stuff, but there's always going to be those extras around. And even the things that aren't necessarily vegan recipes or special vegan products that they buy, there's always things like nuts. Lots of nuts are put out and stuff like that. And there's just higher calorie stuff that is even sometimes accidentally vegan that we do have to navigate. And what am I going to do this year? I've really, really pondered that this year a whole bunch because I feel better than I have in forever, forever. And this is the smallest I've ever been. I don't know what I weigh right now, but I can tell you that I'm continuing to lose weight. Last I knew, I was 156, but I can tell by how my clothes are fitting that I've lost more since then throughout that darn scale. So until I go to the doctors again, I have no idea what I weigh. And I'm good with that, but I can tell you it's still moving in the direction that I want. So what am I going to do? Because I'm also really enjoying my food. It isn't so much about just losing the weight, it's about the health and the fitness that I'm getting, but it's also because I don't want my apple, my pomegranates, my pears, my delicious fruits to taste less than amazing. And right now, that's how they taste. I'll tell you what, we made those caramel apples that are dates and apples, that is a Chef AJ recipe. They were almost too sweet for me. They were super, super sweet, and there was no sugar in them. It was just the dates. But I almost was like, I think this is too much for my taste buds now. And I never thought that would happen. I used to be a fudge girl, and the sweeter, the better. That's how I used to be. But now an apple has just the right amount of sweetness for me. And literally, I had a I don't know, Honeycrisp today. And a Honeycrisp apple while I was out with my husband today. And I thought I died and gone to heaven. I really did. It was amazing. And I know now, I've been at this long enough to know that if I indulge in a vegan dessert, if I indulge at all and it's got sugar in it, that apple, the next time I taste it, isn't gonna taste like it did today. So this is so much more than just, oh no. Like I know because I've done it before. I've gone to the holidays and I've let go of some of my rules. I became less strict. All the things that, people say well-meaning to me. And I've just, the one bite won't hurt you. And I've partaken in some of the vegan foods that have been offered to me. And I've done okay. I didn't overeat. I didn't go crazy. I went home and found out, weighed myself over a few days, didn't gain a thing. Didn't gain a thing. But want to know what happened in a couple of weeks? In a couple of weeks, I was sneaking vegan treats. Nothing crazy, nothing overboard. A Justin's peanut butter cup here, a Justin's peanut butter cup there, licking my son's spoon when I've made something with peanut butter for him on it. Natural peanut butter, no oil added, but I'm now licking it in the corner. You get a taste for something richer or sweeter than you've been used to, and you just keep wanting it. You keep thinking about it, and you go back for it, and you go back for it again and again and again. This is what's happened to me. And then after a couple of weeks, you don't realize how many extra calories you're now putting in your mouth and how many times you're just kind of bending your own rules. I hate that word, but just the way that you've been eating that's made you feel so good, you're not doing it as much anymore. And before you know it, at least for me, I can gain 10 pounds like that so easily. But even more than that, you find you're not wanting your greens anymore. You're not wanting your fruit anymore. That's not what you're craving anymore. So you start going back for, like, I don't know, for even me, if I partake in like sugar or anything, goodness, with oil and sugar, that combination, I know that when I'm trying to get it back under control, even if I stop eating the stuff with oil and sugar, I start craving like richer stuff or more stuff to fill that craving. Instead of being satisfied with a half a cup of oatmeal and my fruit loaded in my oatmeal, I'm wanting like a full cup of oatmeal with, like real peanut butter in it and stuff like that. And I'm wanting that more often because I'm trying to still fill that craving that having that sugar in the first place or that oil in the first place gave to me. And it's just, I don't want it because I will do this game for weeks. And I do it every single time. And it's like, yep, Thanksgiving. I can hear it now. It's only one bite. Come on, it's the holidays. It won't hurt you. It will hurt me. I'm a food addict. I am a food addict. And it will hurt me. And it might not hurt me that day, but it will hurt me over time. And then I go into the Christmas season, my birthday through January 2nd. I will be a disaster. I will be a disaster. And then it's back to setting New Year's resolutions. I don't need to set any New Year's resolutions right now. I'm physically active every single day except for one rest day a week. Spiritually, I feel like I'm in a good place. And eating wise, I love where I'm at and I love exactly how I eat, and I'm okay with the pace that I am still getting to a normalized weight with. So I don't need resolutions right now. And I don't want to get to a place where, come the beginning of January, I have to set resolutions that I probably won't keep again. So for me, this holiday season, I'm just going to honor myself the best that I can. And I don't have a million tips for you of how to get you through it. This video is more about a reminder and for you to ask yourself, will that one bite really hurt me? I know that I'm going to try to always have something in my hands, especially when people are eating. I'm going to make sure I've always got a full drink in my hand. I've always got a full plate of something in my hand because you don't really hand people food that are already eating. So that's one of the strategies. I'm bringing a lot of whole food, plant-based foods. And of course, there's going to be a little more indulgent stuff. And when I say that, it means dates will probably be in my one Thanksgiving dessert and nuts will be in it. But I'm planning also on sharing it with several people. So there's no place or room to even overeat that. So those are some of the strategies that I've got. I know that when people are going to be like getting into chips and dip and things like that, because I'm a sweet craver, but then I get in when they start not, crunching on that stuff, the chips and stuff like that, I get it. I want that too. So for me, I'm bringing roasted chickpeas. We also, I love these. So these are the naked organic beet chips. There's nothing in here. There's no oil. There's not even salt in here. It's just beets. And so I'm gonna pick up a couple of these. They have a naked carrot chip as well. No oil, no salt in it. Just the carrots, just the beets. And they're just dehydrated, and but they're crunchy. They're like massively crunchy. So I'm gonna make some roasted chickpeas. I'm gonna bring the Rhythm organic beets chips, and I'm gonna try to bring some of the carrot ones. And so that's gonna be my crunchy stuff. If I want to, I can bring some salsa and maybe make some corn tortilla chips in the air fryer and bring a big bag of those, because I'm going away for the holidays for a couple of days to someone else's house, someone else's environment, not my own clean environment. I'm going to an environment that is not clean in any way. So I've got to be prepared. So the crunchy stuff, organic beet chips and carrot chips and roasted chickpeas. And if I don't think that's enough, I'll probably do some corn tortillas and bring salsa. So that's the crunchy factor. Then the sweet factor, I'm bringing a bunch of fruit, and I am going to bring some dates and some one dessert. And that's it. So I've got like the sweet thing taken care of. I've got the crunchy, salty thing taken care of. I'm bringing my own main dish for Thanksgiving. I'm very excited about my Thanksgiving meal, but it's all whole food plant-based, and I'll take lots of pictures and throw them up on the Plants to the Rescue group so you can see what we ate. I am planning on staying 100% compliant through Thanksgiving, through Christmas, through forever. Yeah, you heard me, forever. I don't ever plan on adding oil and sugar back into my life again, because I have an allergy to it. And that's where what I really feel deep in my heart. I have an allergy to sugar and oil. It makes me sick. How does it make me sick? I'm a food addict and I'm in recovery. And just like with alcohol or any other drug, you can't take that first drink. You can't take that first sip. And I know it's not like that for everybody, but it is like that for me. And I need to really, really, really take that into consideration and keep that truth close to my heart. And it isn't about getting to some number on a scale. It's about not being sick anymore, not feeling sick anymore, and not giving into compulsions anymore, being in control, having not everything be about food. Like, I'd love to go for a family walk with the extended family. I'd love to, hike in the woods. Life is so different to me now. Where before, when I would eat for the holidays, it would be like eat, sit in front of the TV, feel super uncomfortable, sometimes fall asleep, wake up. That whole rest of the pie would call to me, and I'd eat a whole pie myself in one day because it would just call to me hour after hour. And I'd be sick. And then once that sick feeling went away for a little while, I'd eat again and get sick again. I don't want that. And then I would have, horrible heartburn. I'd wake up the next morning. As soon as my eyes opened, I was already thinking about the pie again, if there was any left. I don't want that anymore. I don't want that lifestyle anymore. It doesn't feel good. It feels so good to have a stomach not be overfull. And if you know what I'm talking about, leave me a message in the comments. Let me know what your strategies are. My strategy is to always have water, some kind of beverage, a hot tea, something in one hand, and a plate in the other. And you know what? I really think that that is a great strategy. And also, be the one to help clean. Be the one to help clean up. Be the one to serve other people. If you can handle serving non-vegan foods, I can handle it. It doesn't bother me. I'm just like, this isn't food. Sometimes it's the meat smells really bad to me, but I'm able to do that. If you make yourself a servant, if you make yourself that person that's super, super active, people won't notice what you are or what you're not eating. And if they do make you something special, I know it sounds horrible, but if you really don't want to offend them and you don't want to hurt their feelings, take the little bit, take a little tiny piece on your plate, make sure you have a napkin. I know this sounds horrible, but if it's someone that you can't say no to for whatever reason, take the little piece, take the napkin, and when they're not looking, just throw your napkin on the top of it and just get rid of it. Just get rid of it when they're not looking and just be like, thank you so much for thinking of me. And if they offer you more, be like, you know what? I'm good. I'm good. Now I'm gonna just enjoy a little bit of my fruit or whatever. There are ways, there are methods. If you have more methods, because confrontation, it doesn't work. It doesn't work, especially with family members. They don't want you to preach to them and they don't want to sit down at their Thanksgiving meal and after during dessert, they don't want to watch forks over knives with you. As much as that might break our hearts that they don't want to, they don't want to. So save that for another day. Save that for like an email message that you send them or something. Don't do it during the holidays. Don't be that person. Just be a loving, grateful person. Be that busy person that's cleaning up and going the extra mile. They'll appreciate it and they'll thank you. And that's my strategy for this year. Like I said, I'd love to hear yours. Please stay tuned. Please stay close to the channel. Help me through, and hopefully I'll help you through too. I hope you have a great day. I wish you all the peace and love in the world. Bye.